We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello friends, let us now consider the last topic of the unit, and which is very important in terms of examination also and as a concept also, and it is known as the Green's theorem. And basically it is nothing but the relation between line integral and double integral, line integral and double integration. So that is the Green's theorem, and let us see what it says. Its statement is like this: let C be a positively oriented, piecewise smooth, simple, closed curve. Now, what does it mean? It means that the curve C is a positively oriented, that means anticlockwise, or even clockwise also work. Piecewise smooth, that means it's continuous, or the function what we are having should be differentiable also. Simple and closed curve. Simple curve means a curve should not cross itself like this. That is not a simple curve. Okay, but this is a simple curve. This is a simple curve. While this one is not a simple curve. This is not simple. So, the we are having one curve, and it's a simple and closed curve, and D be the region enclosed by that curve. So D is a region. Now if P and Q have continuous first order partial derivative on the region D, then the Green's theorem is like this: line integration along the curve C, P dx plus Q dy equal to double integration del Q by del x minus del P by del y, and dx dy, or you can say it is dA. Now we have here two kinds of example. One is we can verify the Green's theorem, and another is we can use the Green's theorem to evaluate the line integral by using the double integration. Let us see one example which is of verification. So the question is, it was asked even in 2018, and it definitely asked for 7 marks. The question is, verify Green's theorem for the function f equal to x square plus y square I minus 2xy j cap, where C is the rectangle in the XY plane bounded by y equal to 0, y equal to b, x equal to 0, and x equal to a. So here we need to verify. Verify means we have to find out the value of the line integral, that means left hand side of the Green's theorem, this one, and we have to find out the value of the right side of the Green's theorem, that means this one, and then we need to prove that both are equal. First let us see here the vector function is x square plus y square I minus 2xy j. So this p dx plus q dy is f dot dr, okay? So this is nothing but f dot dr. Okay, so here we are having f dot dr is x square plus y square dx minus 2xy dy. So this one is p and this one is q. Now let us first evaluate the line integral, that means left hand side. So for that we need the curve, and curve is given by the rectangle. So here x equal to 0, y equal to 0, so this is y equal to 0, this is x equal to 0, then y equal to b. So say suppose this is line y equal to b and x equal to a. So say suppose this is x equal to a line. So this is O A B C, that is the rectangle we are given. This point O 0 0 A A 0, this point B is A B, and this point is 0 comma B. Now we have to integrate, find the line integration. So for that this curve C is now the C1, C2, C3 and C4. So we need to find out the line integration along this C1, then from C2, along C2, then along C3, and then along C4. So our line integration like PDX plus QDY is like this, along C1 plus along C2 plus along C3 plus along C4, okay? And this PDX plus QDY, PDX plus QDY, PDX plus QDY, PDX plus QDY. So here we are having the f dot dr, that is x square plus y square dx and minus 2xy dy. This we need to find, but that is the sum of the all four line integrals. So first let us find along C1. Now along C1, so C1 is nothing but this C1. So C1 is a line, and that line is what? That line is y equal to 0, and x is from 0 to a, and y is 0, that means dy is also 0. So along C1, x square plus y square dx minus 2xy dy equal to, now see, y0 dy0. So y0 and dy0. So y0 and this dy is also 0. So we have x square dx only. And x is from 0 to a. So its integration is x cube by 3 from 0 to a. And so that is a cube by 3. So this is along c1. Now we find along c2. So this is along c1. Now we find along c2. So along c2, now c2 is this one, and that is nothing but what? This line is x equal to a line. And what about the y? Y is from, y is 0 here and y is b here. So y is from 0 to y equal to b. Now x is a constant, so dx is 0. So along c2, x square plus y square dx minus 2xy dy. Now dx is 0, so this is 0. X is a here, so I need to write x as a here. So minus 2ay dy. And y is from 0 to b. So its integration is minus 2a y square by 2 from 0 to b. So this is nothing but minus a b square. So that is number 2. Now we find line integral along c3. Now line integration along c3. So c3 is this much. This one is c3. And this line is y equal to b. This line is y equal to b. And x is from where to where? X is a here and x is 0 here. So x is from a to 0. So y equal to b and x equal to a to x equal to 0. Do not write x equal to 0 to x equal to a because our direction is like this one. Y equal to b and therefore dy is 0. Now along c3. So x square plus y square dx minus 2xy dy equal to, now dy is 0, y is b. So this is x square plus b square dx and x is equal to a to 0. So this is equal to x cube by 3 plus b square x and x equal to a to 0. So upper limit is 0 minus lower limit x is a. So this is a cube by 3 plus b square a. So this is nothing but minus a cube by 3 minus a b square. So this one is number 3. Now along c4, this is the curve along c4. So this is a line and that line is x equal to 0 and y is from b to y is 0 here. Okay. So line is x equal to 0 and y equal to b to y equal to 0. So this is dx 0. And line integration along c4, x square plus y square dx minus 2xy dy. Now dx is 0, x is also 0. So this is 0 and this x is also 0. So the integrand is 0 here. And so the value is 0 here. And therefore, the left hand side, that means line integration along C, x square plus y square dx minus 2xy dy equal to, so that is from 1, 2, 3 and 4. We have to add all that 1, 2, 3 and 4. So 1 is a cube by 3. Then 2 minus ab square. Then 3 minus a cube by 3 minus ab square. And 4, 0. So, this is nothing but minus 2 times a, b square. This is the left hand side of the Green's theorem. Now, we need to verify. That means we need to find the right hand side also. So, let us find the right hand side now. What is right hand side of the Green's theorem? Right hand side of the Green's theorem is double integration over the d or over the region r del q by del x minus del p by del y. You can write r or you can write d. Del q by del x minus del p by del y dA, or you can say dx dy. This is right side of the Green's theorem. Now what is p here? P is x square plus y square. Q minus 2xy. Del p by del y. That is del p by del y. So this is 0 and this is 2y. And del q by del x, so minus 2y. And here del q by del x minus del p by del y, so that is minus 2y minus 2y. Do take care, even in a little mistake of sign will make this is 0, but it is not. So that is minus 4y. So double integration over d, del q by del x minus del p by del y dA equal to, this one is minus 4y, this is dx dy. Now double integration, so limits of x and limit of y. Now see, we are given the rectangle, okay? So we can have the limit here, x equal to 0 to a, y equal to 0 to b. So we take any first, whatever, say x equal to 0 to a, y equal to 0 to b. So this is equal to minus 4, integration first with respect to x, so that y is constant, you can write here y equal to 0 to b, y, integration is x, this is 0 to a and dy. So minus 4, y equal to 0 to b, integration y, this value is a. So this is minus 4 a and integration of y is y square by 2, 0 to b. And this is equal to minus 2 and 4, so this is 2 a and this is b square. So this is a right side of the Green's theorem, minus 2ab square. and here it is left side is minus 2 ab square. So see, the Green's theorem, how it is easy if you can evaluate by double integration. It takes very little time. So from this star and you can say this double, Green's theorem is verified. So that is the way we can solve the example verification of Green's theorem. Let us take one more example. Verify Green's theorem. So you have to solve only if it is asked verify, then only you take verification, that means left side, right side. If it is not asked verify or you only ask evaluate, you use either left side or right side, whatever the easy you want. This was asked in 17. The question is verify Green's theorem for line integration along the curve C y minus sin x dx plus cosine x dy, where C is the boundary of the region bounded by the lines y equal to 0, x equal to pi by 2, and y equal to 2x by pi. Okay. So here also we are having verification. So let us now see, this one is our p dx plus q dy y minus sin x dx plus cosine x dy. So this one is p and this one is q. Now first we need, say suppose if you want to find out the line integration, what is the Green's theorem? So Green's theorem is, so here also we should write first what is the Green's theorem. So Green's theorem is line integration along C, if it is closed, you can write closed like this also, p dx plus q dy is equal to double integration over the region D del q by del x minus del p by del y dx dy, or you can write dA also. Okay. So now the Green's theorem is line integration along C p dx plus q dy equal to double integration over D del q by del x minus del p by del y dx dy, or you can write dA. So we first write, find the value of this line integration, and then we can find the value of this double integration, and we see both are the equal. Okay. So now, so for that we need to draw the region, the curve C. Now what is the curve C? Y equal to 0, x equal to pi by 2, y equal to 2x upon pi. So y equal to 0, so this is the line y equal to 0, x axis. Then x equal to pi by 2, so x equal to pi by 2, so this is, say suppose line x equal to pi by 2, and y equal to 2x by pi, so y equal to 2 by pi x, that means it is of the form y equal to mx. So that is nothing but like this. okay. You can have like this. So this line is y equal to 2 by pi x. Okay. This point is, say this is O, this is say A, and that is x pi by 2 y 0. This is say B, so x pi by 2, and if you put pi by 2 here, so y is 1. Okay, this point is pi by 2 1, and if we take this direction, this is c1, this is c2, and this one is c3. So we need to find along c1, along c2, and along c3. So our this one pdx plus qdy, you can say, equal to along c1 plus along c2 plus along c3, okay, and you can write out this. So first we find along c1. So let us first find the value along c1. So now what is c1? C1 is this curve, and that means y equal to 0, and x is from 0 to pi by 2, and dy is 0. Now along c1, this integration y minus sin x dx plus cos x dy. Now y 0, dy is also 0, and x is from 0 to pi by 2. So this is minus sin x dx, only that. And so here we take the integration of sin x is minus cos x, so this is a cosine x, and this is 0 to pi by 2, this is 0 and minus 1, so this is minus 1. Okay. Now, along C2, along C2, this is C2, and along C2, the line is what? X equal to pi by 2. This is the line x equal to pi by 2. And y is from 0 to 1. And x equal to pi by 2, so dx is 0. So along c2, okay. When we write along C1, it's not a closed curve, so we can in fact write only line integral. So along C2, y minus sin x dx plus cosine x dy. Now dx 0, and x is pi by 2. X is pi by 2. And y is from 0 to 1. X is pi by 2. What is cosine pi by 2? 0. So integration itself is 0. Okay. Now along C3. So along C3, This is the curve C3. But then that is nothing but y equal to 2 by pi x. So along C3 y equal to 2 by pi x. So dy equal to 2 by pi dx. So if everything is in terms of x, so for x is from where to where? So here x is 1 here, sorry. Here x is pi by 2, x coordinate of b this pi by 2, and here the x coordinate is 0. So here x moves from pi by 2 to 0. So along C3 y minus sin x dx plus cosine x dy, and this is equal to, now y is 2 by pi x, so y is 2 by pi x minus sin x, so minus sin x dx plus cosine x and dy is 2 by pi dx, and x is from pi by 2 to 0. So x is from pi by 2 to 0, this is a 2 by pi x minus sin x plus 2 by pi cosine x dx. So we need to take the integration 2 by pi x square by 2. Integration of sin x is minus cosine x, so minus and minus plus cosine x plus 2 by pi, integration of cosine x is sin x, and x equal to pi by 2 to 0. So here you need to take care. So let us take upper limit, x 0, so this is 0, x 0 cosine 0 is 1, x 0 sin 0 is 0, then minus lower limit, x is pi by 2, so this is 1 upon pi, and x square, so this is pi square by 4, then plus cosine pi by 2, 0, plus 2 by pi, and sine pi by 2 is 1, so this is 1, minus 1 pi cancel, so pi by 4, then minus 2 by pi. So this is our third, and therefore from 1, 2 and 3, line integration along C y minus sin x dx plus cosine x dy equal to, so 1 is minus 1, then 2, 0, and 3 plus 1 minus pi by 4 minus 2 by pi, so it is minus pi by 4 minus 2 by pi. This is one side of the Green's theorem. Now let us find the other side. So other side is this one, del q by del minus del p by del y. Now, what is P here? Y minus